about 24 hours after we left Pollock Rip Channel. We've had reasonably heavy weather, three reefs last night for a while. We've got two reefs in now. So.
Yay! You like sailing, this is it.
Taking time though. Two reefs in at the moment. Broad reach. Public wharf at Lunenburg. With minor problems coming in, the engine stopped for a while, apparently due to a clogged filter. Ben's going to put up our flag. It's the same flag that Iona flew. There we go. Welcome to Canada. There's Dick taking a picture of the same dramatic event. St. Peter's Road, it's called, just outside the Charlottetown Harbour. We're waiting for a Coast Guard man called Joe to come on board as crew. It's been a somewhat bizarre series of events. It started off this morning when I came back from dropping off our rental car, and poor Dick Wilder was literally in tears outside the Harbour Master's office there at the marina with his bag packed. He felt dizzy early in the morning. Gone to see a doctor who told him he had a blood pressure of 160 over 102 and that he probably ought to go home and see his own cardiologist, so he promptly started to arrange that. That left us with a third crew member, and we poked around all day, spoke to Gerard McPhee and Vic, what was the other guy's name? Vic something?
It's in the log.
It's in the log. And of course, as you might expect, we didn't strike lucky. We tried the yacht club, yeah, but there are not many people can take off with it. The next time we'll be in civilization is a month from now. We're heading up to the Magdalen Islands today and tonight, and from then on up the west coast of Newfoundland. However, by sheer chance, the Coast Guard, Canadian Coast Guard, stopped by about 4:30 or so to give us a courtesy safety inspection. Two very charming young men made a charade of going through the safety inspection, but we told them our troubles, and would you believe, just as we were chugging out of the harbour just after 6 o'clock, they came zooming up in their little Zodiac with the coxswain of another Coast Guard Zodiac, who said he thought he could make it, and after some slippery talk from us about how interesting it would be and how we could easily get a month off, he went and called his chief petty officer, who happened to be in Halifax, and called us on the radio and said yes, he was coming. So here we are, to make a long story short, anchored in the bay with the sun setting, waiting for Joe to appear. As soon as he appears, we'll start the engine, Shanghai. I'm telling you, he doesn't need to get up till the morning, and by the time he wakes up, he'll be on the way to the Magdalen Islands, and it'll be too late to do anything. We'll have another crew member for the next month before we get to St. John's, which is in about a month, on August 4th, when Ginny joins the boat. So we'll see how he works out. He seems a very nice young man, but he's got no sailing experience. But of course he was trained by the Coast Guard, so we'll see what that means.
Taken. Here comes our third crew member, the new one, Joe, delivered courtesy of the Charlottetown Coast Guard. Certainly looks like him. So, this is the most unique crew delivery we've ever had.
I just thought I ought to get a video of this. I've never had a crew come from the Coast Guard before. If you don't mind.
I didn't know how much gear to pack, so I just, well, I just threw a bunch of stuff together.
Don't forget, you got to take it away, so.
Yeah. If worst comes to worst, I can always dump it in the trash can.
No. This is the approach to the Magdalen Islands.
Approach is not
just after happy hour.
Yeah.
If you notice, it's named after the authoress of Anne of Green Gables. Madeleine, so we've been putting the fair weather gear out to dry, but they just took it back in case it starts to rain. So there's our Canadian flag up. And in the hills here, we've got snow still. A few trawlers and things like that at this dock. Very deep water here. As usual, hundreds of feet, just a few feet from the shore, so you need a dock to tie up to. This is sunset at Bond Bay, and there's Gros Marn Mountain, which I believe is the largest in Newfoundland. To shatter that. And some of the locals came down to do some fishing.
But you have to go up in the pulpit there to get a decent shot of everything.
We're going to take a walk over to the Indian cemetery, the archaeological digs and things. We stopped by the museum this morning. This was a center for what's called the Archaic Maritime Indians. Lived here 4,000 years ago. Archaic Maritime Indian site at Port Aux-Choix. Pan around here, you can see some of the diggings there. This is where the archaeologists were beavering away to find the remains. These are
These are not the same people that left the bones at where the museum is, I believe. These are Indians, whereas the bones are Eskimo. Dorset, or a Grosswater tribe of Eskimo, I believe. For people who collect driftwood, I imagine this must be a paradise. This is the windward side of the island. Today is very calm, but normally I imagine there's a good sea break in here. And as you can see, it's a graveyard of driftwood. We imagine all kind come across from Quebec and Labrador, which are across the Belle Island Straits there. And as you'll see, we've succeeded in getting a winged out jib here on a very foggy and wet Newfoundland day. Victor's sailing the boat, dead downwind. Nice wind actually. There you can see the vane. There you can see it's a dead run. And so we've set the whisker pole after much swearing and cursing and getting the lines all fouled up. And you can see the visibility is probably 200 or 300 yards, I imagine. We passed two trawlers, both of which are sawn radar. Labrador, which we can just see on our port side. First landfall in Labrador, a small village called locally Lancy Lou, which is a corruption of Lance or Lou, Beach of the Wolf. There it is, it's quite a large looking place. And then just off on our port beam here is the lighthouse of Point Amour. And here's a small settlement, 1,000 or so people fishing. It's actually very different than Newfoundland. There are beaches and very clear water. If the water temperature wasn't 39°F, you could think you're in the Caribbean. Here are the fish drying platforms, tables. And there in the distance is the only coastal road, which ends in Red Bay, 35 miles north of here. So we'll sail there tomorrow. That'll be the end of the road. We'll sail on a bit further. Ate one. The fisherman was frying them up. They gave me one to eat, and they're quite tasty, actually. Very tasty. There it is. And what are you going to do with it? Eat it? Let it go. It's not a very pretty fish, is it? Hold it up for the camera, would you? This is just motoring along the Labrador coast. There's really no wind today at all. And you can see that even though it's July 16th, there's snow pockets coming down to the shore there. You can see our first iceberg a few miles to the north. We'll probably pass it on the way to Chateauvay tomorrow or the day after. There it is in the middle of the screen. So we'll go and have a look at that. It's not too foggy. In a couple of days. This is Red Bay. Very quiet.
Farza Park in the white building is the end of the road on the Labrador coast of pavement. Beyond that it's Moose Trail. And here's a scan, and you know, there, guess who that is coming towards us? sort of looking like a tourist or just off the boat.
There's the boat. You can just see the mast. See? If you take a shot of the boat, the Labrador Star there.
That's a fish factory.
So we're at the end of the road.
Here it is again.
Keep right on to the end of the road. Keep right on.
The cemetery. One sunny tress. One curl that decked the little head. Give the cold clay one last caress. Weep, mother, weep. Thy child is dead. How about that for graveyard poetry? This is the center of Red Bay. That's where the Basque remains are. We'll go and look at them. Across the straits, there's Saddle Island, which was the site of the Basque whaling fleet between 1550 and 1600. Sometimes 20 galleons would come from the Basque region of Spain and France to catch bowhead whales in the Belle Island Straits, which is just there. In fact, you can just see on a clear day, I think you might see. This was where the straits necked down and the whales went through in large numbers. They estimate they caught 20,000 in 50 years and just about decimated them. So, they had settlements here that lasted 6 months. Occasionally they wintered over if they were caught by the ice, and of course many of them died of scurvy in that case. It's near Saddle Island. There's the wreck. A freighter that suffered the same fate as the Basque whale of the San Juan. It was overwhelmed by a windstorm. It comes down from the hills at certain times. Bay from Red Bay. And here's a nice iceberg that's popped up. Almost certainly a ground there. Floating lump of ice that makes it dangerous to sail at night here. There, a growler. Just, very difficult to pick up on radar. We were able to get it because we knew it was there, but I think the casual sweep would never see it because it just sticks up a few feet. It's not a very good radar target. Dead run at the moment, just about. Not quite a dead run, the jib's just about falling. There it goes. And this iceberg here. Not much the blues coming out and up because the monitor on the TV camera is black and white. A few minutes later as we get behind it. So here we are. Running into Chateau Bay. In the distance there is Belle Isle, after which the straits are named. We've been sailing it, panning round. We've got our icebergs tucked away. There are actually two big ones, and then others in the distance you can't see them. That's the light at the entrance to Chateau Bay, which is here. A small community used in summer only by fishermen. This is, as I say, 30 miles north of the end of the Labrador Road, so there's not too much in the way of communication to this place. Henley's Harbour here.
from the old dock.
Vessel. The island, and here through a small cut, or tickle as it's called in this part of the world, there's a fairly large iceberg. It's breaking up, you can see the pieces floating away. It's the ground, almost certainly the pieces go by grinding on the rocks underneath. Labrador sailing. Now you can tell up on our port near the visitor there. It's foggy until just a minute ago. Saw the berg on radar. The entrance to Battle Harbour, which is a somewhat complicated entrance, further complicated by a large iceberg sitting in the channel. Battle Harbour itself is there. We have to go around and loop in from the other side. We're heading north, but we have to go northwest, northwest edge to get a turn around to come back in. Yo, taking pictures of this thing here. An iceberg on the approaches to Battle Harbour. Not a very big one, we've seen much bigger, but still, it's a nice shape. Everybody's fed up with icebergs right now, but this is the berg guarding the entrance to Battle Harbour. Quite a monster, there's lots of bits falling off to leeward. We'll probably take a picture of that tomorrow when we come to Mary. A vessel called the Strait Carrier 2. Scene at Battle Harbour. That tickle there is a way out if you know what you're doing, but we don't. So we won't be going out that way. We've got the long but easier way. That's the lighthouse of Double Island in the background. So we'll go and look at some shipwright carpentry in the warehouses. Very old.
much air about it. Here's the grounded iceberg in the St. Louis Strait. Gorgeously hot, beautiful day. We've been overtaken by a tanker, small tanker that was at Mary's. Here we are on the main and jib, scooging along the island. The funny thing is that while they're so hot that they can be lying out sunbathing, on the bow we've got our old friend. So, on the 21st we turn south, back to Newfoundland. And we'll have one last look at the coast of Labrador. Early sunlight. Small berg over there, and a big one here. Here's a grounded iceberg. Ben just said that the depth finder is showing 230 feet. So it shows you how much of this is below the level of the sea. Which is why we're not going too close. Probably 100 yards from the brute. North end of the northern peninsula of Newfoundland. And the interesting thing here is that just in that bay in the center of the camera now is Lanceau Meadow, where the Vikings had a settlement. Fox Canada building. This is the bay in which the houses were built. And here's the reproduction of the site. Sod houses. We'll now go inside. Unfortunately, it's raining fairly heavily. This is a reproduction of the small rowing boats and the sod house. Pretty small and pretty sparse. Things like that. We're going to have an authentic Norse client.
I think down around
the smoke just goes up through that hole in the ceiling. In the roof.
They're drilling some areas.
You can see the fire burning out. Feet thick, made of layers of sod and then sand and gravel in between. And the roofs were about 2 feet roughly. And then there was snow on top of the roof, so in fact they probably stayed fairly cozy. Had enough food to eat. This is Hooping Harbour, according to the guide. There's a government wharf and several private wharfs, but it looks like we've discovered another resettled outport, because in fact all the wharves have fallen into the water and all the houses have been abandoned. Shame. Wonderful fjord. For a few minutes and look at the old place. Very rotted. The dock's got big holes in it.
Hooping Harbour to, we're actually going to a place called La Cie, but we're going via some islands called the Horse Islands. And there's the iceberg that was actually on our bow when we left, that little notch there, you can see. And then on our port here, we've got two unusual icebergs, flat ones rather than triangular. And this one's very, very striped, green stripes in it. Yeah, they both show very poorly on radar. Pretty nice that have substantial underwater shape and probably weigh several tons. So if you sail into one, it's like sailing into a large rock. This is approaching the passage between Horse Island. Ice piled up there on the rocks. Right. Good brisk wind. Gate. Newfoundland. Nice fishing village on a beautiful day. An enormous change in the weather. Getting things out to dry. To climb up to this hill and have a look round. Joe went home today. He got a ride to Gander Airport, which is about 100 kilometres south of here. And he's going to fly back to Charlottetown. So Ben and I will take the boat to St. John's, Newfoundland, in a series of easy steps. A little late, it's been a long passage from Pogo. And ahead we've got quite a pod of whales with big flukes that keep coming up. You see the birds are everywhere. Somewhat windy place. We sailed in, having come down from Elliston, in winds of 25, sometimes even touching 30. Today it's blowing hard, but it is a nice anchorage. We anchored here, and they're doing the very best to make the town a sort of reconstructed Victorian jewel, if you like. That's the oldest Anglican church in Newfoundland there. There's some other nice churches. Crossing Trinity Bay on a somewhat brisk day. Little reefed main. Likes to get some fresh air now and again. Then steering all the fluky winds that we're getting off this headland here.
All at 1 o'clock.
Yep, there he is. Yep, there he goes, there's his tail. Thank you. organization. Because here's the entrance to St. John's. And there's Signal Hill. Coming up through the Narrows. This is the the wharf at St. John's. Today we're going to go up and look at the Regatta. There's old Fiona tied up. We've been here a couple of days. These schooners here, this one and another one behind there. Take people out for harbour tours and look at the whales just outside the Narrows. This morning. They're half an hour ahead of Newfoundland for some inexplicable French reason. As usual, it's foggy here. Ginny Rining is on board. Just peering into the fog, we had to be guided in today by a couple of guys in a skiff. Lovely day sail. We're going to the deck tonight, but the entrance to the Vidar Lake is about 31 miles away. Yeah, this is going through the channel at the north end of the Vidar Lake. And we're in these rips, which may be hard to see on the video. But there's a tremendous current flowing out, which
unfortunately we're going against. So we're moving slowly. That's the entrance. A nice little port we got into late last night. We're leaving this afternoon later from Masco Cove. This is Bert Cooper's boat. We met him. It's called Heart's Content. We met him in St. John's, 89. This is the public wharf. Very nice little village. Famous lighthouse there at the end. Been there quite a long time, that lighthouse. Typical Brador Lake lighthouse. And it seems to have just about stopped. And there you see the little boathouse that belongs to Anna Russell. So in a few minutes we'll take the dinghy ashore and see if we can get some fireworks going. The Russell's house, hold him up!
All the way.
Up this hill here. Swim. In Maskell Cove.
Say, Ben, where's the ladder?
Unfortunately, we don't have the ladder rigged. Come on, just swim vigorously. There we are.
Where's the ladder?
We haven't got the ladder up. Here comes Ben with the ladder.
You're awfully slow about that ladder.
Hey, I haven't even had coffee yet. God.
All right. I'll
oh, well. I don't know why the ladies on the crew always seem to jump into Maskell Cove here. Curious thing. Look at the bolts that came up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, one in the mid, 7.
Some people that have some sense in this world. And there are others.
There are others.
I don't know about that.
Mayor Florence Chadwick. Unless you wouldn't know who Florence.
That's very refreshing. It's
oh,
like,
I'm sure it's refreshing.
It's not even cold.
This is Terence Bay, but a few miles west of the Sambro Lighthouse, and we just pulled in here last night about 9:30 for an anchorage for the night, and we're going to leave for Maine today via Cape Sable. Gale force winds are forecast for tomorrow, which is amazing considering the weather. Now it's flat as a pancake, but you never know in this part of the world. So anyway, there's CBC and the troops getting the washing up out of the way. Miss the CBC. I'm taking a picture of you cleaning the stove, Ginny.
How are you? Well, I'm so glad.
Domestic. Yep.
By the little domestic touches of life.
Leaving Bar Harbor. And Ginny has gone back home. And here we have young Tom Lamont. Tennessee, who joined us for a couple of weeks. We'll go to Long Island.
there in the distance. A big cruise ship came into Bar Harbor this morning, so we're probably pulling out at the right time. There's Cadillac Mountain. Just chugging down a bit here until we can get a nice lift and sail a bit. Right. Osprey in Pretty Marsh Harbour on the west side. Missed its fish again. So we'll try and get a shot of the Osprey catching something. There, got him. A visit to Little Cranberry Island. Those people just left under sail. And here's the way they get trucks over to the island. In the background you can see Mount Desert Island. And then, there is Cranberry, Little Cranberry, to be strictly accurate. We went ashore this morning, walked around to the other side. Nice place actually, I liked it better than Monhegan. Certainly better than Matinicus. Lots of day trippers though, coming over on these launches. Toothacre Bay and Swan's Island, and we're socked in with rain, but we're going to have a couple of lobsters for Tom and Louise, who joined the boat. Here she is.
Hello.
And at the moment, Ben is just going to do a tentacle test.
Aha.
Broke
up. They're ready.
And then also over here,
you want
a sausage and spam for Ben and I, who are not too keen on the scavengers of the deep, namely lobsters.
This was
the... There we are. Disgusting lobsters bought in Swan's Island.
Barnacles.
Yeah, one's got barnacles. There. Okay, Tom, give me a synopsis of your lobster.
It's not raining out there.
Yeah, it's raining. Usual rake, heavily loaded too. Lovely day. There's another one.
Ladder up, Mr. Engineer. Gotta go far away from here. While the man at the fly shovels on the coal, stick your head out the camp, watch the drive and roll, see the times and the roads go.
What's the name of these islands, Louise, again? Merchant's Row. Oh, well, here's some of the most beautiful islands in Maine, according to the guidebook. Very light wind, but we're slowly sailing along. The other lug rig boat. Harbour Island here.
One of the many harbour islands.
Dang.
There's some canoes
around there.
Kayakers on the bow.
Kayakers. Can't really turn around that easily.
Ready? Of course.
Butter Island, an island I've not visited since 1967. It's Ben and Louise's birthday today.
60 years old.
Are you?
Well, I'm finished 59, starting my 60th year.
Ah, you're 59 today.
Oh, into 60. And life begins at 60.
I'm not sure. As I say, Tom's learning celestial navigation. Ben's getting the dinghy ready. Louise was looking at birds. And here... Butter Island. Looks like they've been doing some logging.
Yeah, I can't imagine it has that much wind.
Well, you're on camera if you want to say something significant about clearing out the trees.
Do not cut.
Well, I'm not going to cut. I've only got my pocket knife with me.
Save, oh save.
Find compost inside the tree.
There you can see some schooners sailing in Penobscot Bay. Bay at the southeast end of Butter. That's south of us is Eagle Island, and then there's North Penobscot Bay. Way in the distance, you can't see it in the murk, would be Camden, Rockport, Rockland. Louise and Ben have got anonymous birthdays today. So we're going to bring it on deck. You notice it's donut shaped. We made that in the same pan we baked the bread in, going around Cape Horn.
Out.
Oh, it blew out anyway. The wind blew. That's very appropriate. Right?
Put it on the cabin top there. Happy birthday?
Well, we haven't. You have to weigh that when we cut it, right?
Did you?
One, two, three.
Happy birthday to us. Happy birthday to
dear Louise.
Happy birthday, dear
Louise and Ben.
Happy birthday to us.
Afternoon, Dixieland on the waterfront at Goody and Stevens, famous. Habits. Here is Tom steering the boat on a broad reach up the Sheepscot River. Doing a nice 7 knots. Louise is identifying flowers found on the Mariscove Island. Ben is contemplating his next reincarnation.
My navel.
And over there is Seguin. We'll probably go around tomorrow. This is Fire Island Harbour on the Sheep's Cup River. Very scenic little place. The yacht club provide free moorings. The yacht club are located on this island here. Seems like a very exclusive community. There's no bridge to it. There it is there. Guy came and told us all about the facilities once we picked up the mooring. Sort of a greeter. Very nice of it. Lots of mosquitoes here though. It's a little lobster coffee shop thing on the dock there. Vain.
See your